Today our lecture is on the subject of second year physiology. It will explain the history of physiology, the models presented by different physiologists, cell membrane and their functions will also be explained. Please don't forget to subscribe, like and share our YouTube channel. Spread the word of knowledge. Knowledge will increase. Maybe your friend will benefit a lot from what you say. So let's start our regular lecture today, History of Physiology. The study of human physiology began with Hippocrates in ancient Greece around 420 BC. He is often referred to as the father of medicine in recognition of his lasting contribution to the field as the founder of Hippocratic School of Medicine. Aristotle, who applied critical thinking and emphasis on the relationship between structure and function, he was a Greek philosopher and polymath during the classical period in ancient Greece. Galen was the first to use experiments to probe the body's functions. He was a physician, surgeon, and philosopher in the Roman Empire. Galen influenced the development of various scientific disciplines, including anatomy, physiology, pathology, pharmacology, and neurology, as well as philosophy and logic. The term physiology was introduced by the French physician Jean Fenelon. As a French physician who introduced the term physiology to describe the study of the body's function, he was the first person to describe the spinal canal. Spinal canal. Jean Fenelon was the first physiologist to describe the spinal cord and to introduce the term physiology. In the 17th century, William Harvey described the circulatory system, pioneering the combination of close observation with careful experiment. He was an English physician who made influential contribution in anatomy and physiology. He was the first known physician to describe completely and in detail the systemic circulation and properties of blood being pumped to the brain and the rest of the body by the heart. In the 19th century, physiological knowledge began to accumulate at a rapid rate with the cell theory of Matthias Schelden and Theodore Schwann in 1838. The organisms are made up of cells, as a German botanist and co-founder of cell theory, along with Theodor Schwann and Rudolf Virchow. He was a German physician and physiologist. His most significant contribution to biology is considered to be the extension of cell theory to animals. Other contributions include the discovery of Schwann cells in the peripheral nervous system, the discovery and study of pepsin, the discovery of the organic nature of yeast, and the invention of the term metabolism. Claude Bernard created the concept of milieu intérieur, internal environment. He was a French physician and physiologist. Claude Bernard, one of the greatest of all men of science. Among many other accomplishments, he was one of the first to suggest the use of blind experiments to ensure the objectivity of scientific observations. Walter Cannon, later said, was regulated to a steady state in homeostasis. He was an American physiologist, professor, and chairman of the Department of Physiology at Harvard School. He coined the term fight or flight response, and he expanded on Claude Bernard's concept of homeostasis. The fight or flight response is a physiological reaction that occurs in response to a perceived harmful event, attack, or threat to survival. Here I give you an example that you are in a forest and suddenly a wild lion appears. What will be your decision then? Would you like to fight this wild lion or run away? We call this acute stress response, fight or run. If you are brave, you can fight. But if you are weak, then running away is the only way to be safe. In the 20th century, the physiologist Knut Schmidt, Nelson, and George Bartholomew extended their studies to comparative physiology and ecophysiology. He was a prominent figure in the field of comparative physiology and professor of physiology. Most recently, evolutionary physiology has become a distinct discipline. Evolutionary physiology is the study of physiological evolution, which is to say the manner in which the functional characteristics of individuals in a population of organisms have responded to selection across multiple generations during the history of the population. In evolutionary physiology, George Bartholomew discusses the various changes that take place within man. Just like when a person naturally has a desire for sex, he feels inferior in morals. It was a little introduction to physiology. Now let's start with our main lecture. Physiology, from ancient Greek physis, meaning nature, origin, and logia, meaning study of, is the scientific study of functions and mechanisms in a living system. So, physiology is the scientific study of functions and mechanisms in a living system. Human physiology studies the mechanical, physical, and biochemical functions that determine the health of an individual, while anatomy studies form. Physiology is the study of function. Human physiology seeks to understand the mechanisms that work to keep the human body alive and functioning through scientific inquiry into the nature of mechanical, physical, and biochemical functions of humans, their organs, and the cells of which they are composed. Changes in physiology can impact the mental functions of individual. Examples of this would be the effects of certain medications or toxic level of substances, change in behavior as a result of these substances is often used to assess the health of individuals. What is cell? All the living things are composed of cells. A single cell is the smallest unit that has all the characteristics of life. Cell is defined as the structural and functional unit of the living body. Structure of cell: cytoplasm, cell membrane, mitochondria, nucleus, DNA, endoplasmic reticulum, lysosome. As we know, there are many organelles inside a cell that contain cell membranes, mitochondria, cytoplasm, nucleus, ribosomes, lysosomes, DNA, endoplasmic reticulum, and so on. General characteristics of cells. Here we will describe the general characteristics of the cell. What is the nutritional value of the cell? How does a cell produce its energy? How does it remove carbon dioxide and other waste products from the body? So look. Each cell in the body needs nutrition and oxygen, produces its own energy necessary for its growth, repair, and other activities, eliminates carbon dioxide and other metabolic wastes, maintains the medium, that is the environment, for its survival. Shows immediate response to the entry of invaders like bacteria or toxic substances into the body, reproduces by division. There are some exceptions like neuron which do not reproduce. Tissue defined as the group of cells have similar function. There are many types of tissues in the body. All the tissues are classified into four major types, which are called the primary tissues. Number one, muscle tissue. Skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. Skeletal muscle, shape of this shape, skeletal muscle, smooth muscles, and cardiac muscles. Nervous tissue, main tissue neuron and supporting cells, dendrites, etc. Epithelial tissue, epithelial, cuboidal tissue, squamous tissue, columnar tissue, and stratified squamous tissue. Connective tissue, loose connective tissue under the skin, adipose tissue. Some organs are composed of all the four types of primary tissues. The organs are of two types, namely tubular or hollow organs and compact or parenchymal organs. Some of the organs in the body are brain, heart, lungs, stomach, intestine, liver, gallbladder, pancreas, kidney, endocrine glands, etc. Tubular or hollow type of organs, tubular tissue, tubular organ, tubular, intestine, lungs, alveoli, tubules, tubular organs. System. The organ system is defined as group of organs that work together to carry out specific organism level, atomic level, molecular level, cellular level, tissue level, organ level, system level. If we talk about systems, we know that before the creation of anybody, an atom comes into being, then a molecule is formed, then molecules come together to form a cell, then many cells come together to form a tissue. After many tissues meet, an organ is formed, then the organs come together to form a system, and thus many bodily systems run a whole body together. Each system performs a specific function. Like digestive system is concerned with digestion of food particles. Excretory system eliminates unwanted substances like kidney. Cardiovascular system is responsible for transport of substances between the organs. Respiratory system is concerned with the supply of oxygen and removal of carbon dioxide. Reproductive system is involved in the reproduction of species. Endocrine system is concerned with growth of body and regulation and maintenance of normal life. Musculoskeletal system is responsible for stability and movements of the body. Nervous system controls the locomotion and other activities, including the intellectual functions. Structure of the cell. Each cell is formed by a cell body and a membrane covering the cell body called the cell membrane. Cell body has two parts, namely nucleus and cytoplasm surrounding the nucleus. Thus, The structure of the cell is studied under three headings: cell membrane, cytoplasm, and nucleus. Structure of cell. Cell membrane. Cell membrane is a protective sheet enveloping the cell body. It is also known as plasma membrane or plasma lemma. This membrane separates the fluid outside the cell called extracellular fluid and the fluid inside the cell called intracellular fluid. The cell membrane is a semi-permeable membrane, so there is free exchange of certain substances between extracellular fluid and intracellular fluid. Thickness of the cell membrane varies from 75 to 111. Composition of cell membrane. It is composed of three types of substances. Number one, protein. Number two, lipids. Protein 45%, lipids 40%, carbohydrates just 5%. Structure of cell membrane. On the basis of structure, cell membrane is called a unit membrane or a three-layered membrane. The electron microscopic study reveals three layers of cell membrane, namely one central electron lucent layer and two electron dense layers. Double layer structure, upper layer, lower layer. This is called glycolipids, carbohydrate molecule, glycoprotein, plasma membrane, protein, and cholesterol. The two electron dense layers are placed one on either side of the central layer. The central layer is a lipid layer formed by lipid substances. The outer two layers are protein layers formed by proteins. Cell membrane contains some carbohydrate molecules also. Structural model of cell membrane. Danieli Davison model. It was the first proposed basic model of membrane structure. It was proposed by James F. Danieli and Hope Davison in 1935, and it was accepted by scientists for many years. This model was basically a sandwich of lipids covered by proteins on both sides. Sandwich type: upper layer, lower layer or inner layer, and between the space protein form distinct layers are sandwich type of model. Same like this. In 1975, J.D. Robertson replaced Danieli Davison model by unit membrane model on the basis of electron microscopic studies. Fluid mosaic model. Later in 1972, J.S. Singer and G.L. Nicholson proposed the fluid mosaic model. According to them, the membrane is a fluid with mosaic of proteins. Mosaic means pattern formed by arrangement of different colored pieces of stone, tile, glass, or other such materials. This model is accepted by the scientists till now. In this model, the proteins are found to float in the lipid layer instead of forming the layers of the sandwich type model. Lipid layers of cell membrane. The central lipid layer is a bilayered structure. Let me tell you something about lipids. Where and under what conditions are lipids found in our body? It's mainly fats, lipids, fatty acids that are soluble in organ solvents but insoluble in water. Simple lipids includes fats and waxes. Compound lipids include phospholipids and saturated lipids, and extracted lipids include fatty acids, sterols, and alcohols. This is formed by a thin film of lipids. The characteristic feature of lipid layer is that it is fluid in nature and not a solid structure. So the portions of the membrane move from one point to another point along the surface of the cell. The material dissolved in lipid layer also move to all areas of the cell membrane. Major lipids are phospholipids, cholesterol. Number one, phospholipids. Phospholipids are the lipid substances containing phosphorus and fatty acids. Phospholipid molecules are arranged in two layers. Each phospholipid molecule resembles the headed pin in shape. The outer part of the phospholipid molecule is called the head portion. The inner portion is called the tail portion. Head portion is polar and it is soluble in water and has strong affinity for water. Tail portion is the non-polar end. It is insoluble in water and repelled by water. Two layers of phospholipids are arranged in such a way that the hydrophobic tail portion meet in the center of the membrane. Hydrophilic head portions of outer layer face the extracellular fluid, and those of the inner layer face intracellular fluid. Number two, cholesterol. Cholesterol molecules are arranged in between the phospholipid molecules. Phospholipids are soft and oily structure, and cholesterol helps to pack the phospholipids in the membrane. So cholesterol is responsible for the structural integrity of lipid layer of the cell membrane. Functions of lipid layer in cell membrane. Lipid layer of the cell membrane is a semi-permeable membrane, and allows only the fat soluble substances to pass through it. Thus, the fat soluble substances like oxygen, carbon dioxide, and alcohol can pass through this lipid layer. The water soluble substances such as glucose, urea, and electrolytes cannot pass through this layer. Semipermeable membrane. Semipermeable membrane are cellophane or parchment-like membrane that does not allow certain molecules to pass through. They are used for gas separation and medical purposes, just as a sieve is used to clean tea. So does the membrane play a role in the body? What is the size of its hole allows it to pass, and molecules larger than its size do not allow it to pass? Protein layers of the cell membrane. Protein layers of the cell membrane are electron dense layers. These layers cover the two surfaces of the central lipid layer. Protein layers give protection to the central lipid layer. The protein substances present in these layers are mostly glycoproteins. Protein molecules are classified into two categories. Number one, integral proteins are transmembrane proteins. Number two, peripheral proteins are peripheral membrane proteins. Number one, integral proteins. Shape of integral protein. Integral protein are the proteins that pass through entire thickness of the cell membrane from one side to the other side. These proteins are tightly bound with the cell membrane. Examples of integral protein: cell adhesion proteins, cell junction proteins, some carrier transport proteins, channel proteins, some hormones receptors, antigens, some enzymes. These are the examples of integral proteins. Peripheral proteins. In this membrane, proteins are the proteins which are partially embedded in the outer and inner surfaces of the cell membrane and do not penetrate the cell membrane. Peripheral proteins are loosely bound with integral proteins or lipid layer of cell membrane. So these protein molecules dissociate readily from the cell membrane. Examples of peripheral proteins: proteins of cytoskeleton, some carrier proteins, and some enzymes. Functions of proteins in cell membrane. Number one, integral proteins provide the structural integrity of the cell membrane. Channel proteins help in the diffusion of water soluble substances like glucose and electrolytes. Carrier or transport proteins help in the transport of substances across the cell membrane by means of active or passive transport. Pump. Some carrier proteins act as pumps by which ions are transported actively across the cell membrane. Receptor proteins serve as the receptor sites for hormones and neurotransmitters, enzymes. Some of the protein molecules form the enzymes and control chemical reactions within the cell membrane. Antigens. Some proteins act as antigens and induce the process of antibody formation. Cell adhesion molecules or the integral proteins are responsible for attachment of cells to their neighbors or to basal lamina. These are the functions of protein in cell membranes. Carbohydrates of the cell membrane. Some of the carbohydrate molecules present in cell membrane are attached to proteins and form glycoproteins. Some carbohydrate molecules are attached to lipids and form glycolipids. Carbohydrate molecules form a thin and loose covering over the entire surface of cell membrane called glycocalyx. Glycoprotein and glycolipids. Functions of carbohydrates in cell membrane. Carbohydrates, starchy food, an organic compound consisting of carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen. Carbohydrates are found in bread, rice, potatoes, and vegetables. The human body derives about 60% of its energy from carbohydrates. It is a very important source of energy for the human brain and muscles. Carbohydrates do not contain nitrogen. The human body does not have the capacity to store excess carbohydrates. A small amount of glycogen is stored in the liver and muscles. Carbohydrate molecules are negatively charged and do not permit the negatively charged substances to move in and out of the cell. Glycocalyx from the neighboring cells helps in the tight fixation of cells with one another. Some carbohydrate molecules function as the receptors for some hormones. Functions of cell membrane. First function of cell membrane, protective function. Cell membrane protects the cytoplasm and the organelles present in the cytoplasm. Selective permeability. Cell membrane acts as a semi-permeable membrane which allows only some substances to pass through it and acts as a barrier for other substances. Extracellular space, intracellular space, lipid bilayer cell membrane, barrier of cell membrane, absorptive function. Nutrients are absorbed into the cell through the cell membrane. Excretory function. Metabolites and other waste products from the cell are excreted out through the cell membrane. Excretory system, urinary system, kidney, renal tubule, duct of Bellini, collecting tubule and pass out the urine from urethra bladder. Exchange of gases. Oxygen enters the cell from the blood and carbon dioxide leaves the cell and enters the blood through the cell membrane. Alveoli. Maintenance of shape and size of the cell. Cell membrane is responsible for the maintenance of shape and size of the cell, like epithelial cells, immune cell, sex cell, maintenance of shape and size, muscle cell, fat, bone, blood cell, nervous cell, stem cell.